In Cinema 4D Release 19, Maxon has begun work on integrating AMD's ProRender. ProRender is an unbiased path tracer that runs on the CPU and GPU, and it's written using OpenCL, which provides the greatest compatibility for users, regardless of their platform. Getting started with ProRender is as easy as choosing ProRender from the render settings, and then selecting the view panel that you wish to use as the preview panel, and clicking on Start ProRender. Once the preview has started, you can begin adjusting your materials and lighting to see the results show up in the preview. ProRender works hand-in-hand with the new PBR material and light. In fact, it takes the PBR workflow one step further by limiting the available attributes in the interface, providing you with solid guidance on what settings affect the end result, helping you create more realistic materials and lighting with ease. The PBR Lite sees far more options being locked off. This is because all lighting is based on physically accurate reflections of light in the scene, which means far more of the light attributes are not physically plausible. When it comes to working with materials, you will be guided towards working with the reflectance channel. But you are not limited to this, and you can still create materials using the color channel. This allows for easy backwards compatibility between scenes. Most of the utility shaders, like the colorizer or the layer shader, are supported, while other shaders, like noises, will be baked into 2D textures, meaning that the change in workflow between physical and ProRender is minimal. When it comes to rendering your scene, you have a few options in the render settings. This is where you'll set up the offline render, better known as rendering to the picture viewer, and the preview, which is what you see in the view panel. For the most part, these two modes share the same attributes. This is where you'll be able to change the render mode, including direct illumination without shadows, and an ambient occlusion render that can be used for compositing later on. You also have control over depth of field, the number of bounces of light within your scene, the quality of the anti-aliasing as well as the anti-aliasing filter type, a radiance clamp to control overbright values, as well as the default texture resolution, which controls the resolution of the baked textures for ProRender. Another important feature of the preview render is the preview resolution. This allows you to downsample the size of the pixels that are being rendered. While this results in lower quality in the view panel, it can provide faster updates while working with the materials or lights. When it comes to the offline render, you'll also have options for a firefly filter, which can help eliminate stray bright pixels. There's also options to control what elements in the view panel will be rendered. By default, ProRender is going to render progressively, and you have several different ways of controlling how that's going to happen. You can set an iteration count, a time limit in seconds, a error threshold, or set it to never with an iteration count limit. All of these allow precise control over when a render is considered finished. Finally, in the settings, you also have the options to control which graphics cards are going to be used in the render. If you have multiple GPUs, you'll see them listed here. If you right-click in the render settings, you'll also get the option to add a tone mapping effect. This effect gives you control over the lighting inside of your scene. When using the preview in the view panel, these changes will also be applied during the render, providing you with a much better idea of the effect without waiting for the full render to complete. So, with Cinema 4D R19, ProRender provides everyone a chance to experience GPU rendering, regardless of their hardware platform. Be sure to check out the other videos on Cineversity.com to find out more about the other great features in Cinema 4D R19.